Welcome to Infinite Creations, Episode 2. Today is Sunday, October 4th, 2015. I'm Lakshmi, also known as Knitter by Nature on Ravelry and Instagram. Welcome. I hope everyone had a good week. My week was pretty productive in terms of knitting. I did go through a lot of my UFOs and brought some back into rotation. I also been working on setting up my recording space a little bit better. It still needs a little tweaking. I could bring in some more softies, hang the Picasso copy that I painted in college, reorganize the baskets so they're a little bit easier to pull from. What do you guys think? First off, we'll start with what I'm wearing. This is Piper's Journey by Paula of the Knitting Pipeline podcast. It's knit out of Quinson Company Chickadee in the Tweed colorway, and it's 100% American wool. I love this project. I finished this back in July of 2012, and it's a great little neutral piece to throw on. I like the brown color. I also like to knit with gray a lot. Very neutral and goes with anything, and it's a nice little warm layer to throw on. So I'm enjoying wearing that. FOs. I do have a finished object, but I misplaced it. So I won't be able to show you, but I can show you a picture. And I apologize for the poor quality of the picture. It's just a quick snapshot that I took late in the evening after I finished up the hat in low lighting. So this is Graham by Jennifer Adams. It's knit out of Malabrigo Rios in the Solace colorway. My son picked this yarn out especially for a hat for himself when we went to Stitches East last year in Hartford. I think I used a size 6 and 8 needle to knit it up and start with a ribbing, and it has a large bottom band that you can either, you know, leave down or roll up. You actually knit the hat from the inside out. When you're all finished with the hat, you turn it right side out and the pattern is on the wrong side. So I'm really happy with that, how that came out. You can wear it as a nice slouchy hat. It's really soft. It's washable, which is good because who knows, it might be in the wash right now. I never know with those things. Okay, let's move on to whips. I didn't work on my Mystic Fire shawl or my Kelso sweater or the silk scarves or the pumpkin patch socks at all, because I was more interested in finding these projects. That hat had been on the needles for almost a year, and it took less than a couple hours to finish it up because I was on the crown shaping. And I had to kind of make up my own crown shaping because I couldn't find my place in the directions. I think I had it messed up. So I just decided I was going to wing it, did my own crown shaping, and it turned out great. We'll start with my Archangel ankle socks, knit out of Malabrigo sock in the Archangel colorway. Here's the first sock. Now these socks make me think of my son because he was named after the Archangel Zadkiel. And what's so funny is I was going through my stash and I knew I had purchased a skein of Malabrigo sock last year at Stitches, but I couldn't remember what colorway it was. And then I got this when I was vacationing in California. But when I went through my stash, I found a skein of Malabrigo sock, and it's the exact same color. So I'm which is really funny. I guess I like this color a lot. So what I can do is I can always knit a shawl, and I'll probably have lots of yarn left over from the socks, because they're just short ankle socks. I can knit a shawl, and if I run out of yarn, I'll have extra to work with. So it's a plus. It's probably the same, not the same dye lot, but I can always do a border or something, and it would work out just fine. So that's the first sock, and I worked on this a little bit at Open House this week. So I got about a half an inch of stockinette done. Before, I had just finished the ribbing. So now I just have half an inch of stockinette. So I have another inch to go before I start the heel. And it's a plain vanilla sock. I cast on 56 stitches for my foot, and I'm using a size 2 needle. My other sock, the Elm by Cookie A, I worked on just a bit, and I finished chart B. Yay! So it was only about 4 or 5 rows, but I did finish a chart. So let's put this on the needles so you can see. And this is knit out of more yarn that I got while vacationing in California. It's the Forbidden Woolery in the Marvelous colorway. And this is a great knit, but I'm having a little bit of trouble with knitting into the front and back of stitches. It's a little fiddly, so it's going all right, but I'm not sure I would knit this up again. Okay, and then I have some older works in progress to show you. The first of which is The Dream Bird by Nadita. Make sure the stitches don't fall off the needles here. This is knit out of Knit Picks Chroma Fingering in the black color and Noro Silk Garden in the jewel tones. I don't have the ball band, so I don't know which colorway it is, but it starts off this beautiful green and progresses to purples and blues and back to the green. I think it's just beautiful, and it's something I'm not used to wearing so much because I don't wear many jewel tones. I mostly wear neutrals. Once in a while, I'll wear a bright pop of color. Once in a while, like often, actually. But not so much jewel tones. I like pinks and oranges and browns. It took me a little while to figure out where I was in the pattern, and it's really helpful that the pattern is has two formats. It has a step-by-step format and a row-by-row count of stitches. So that was helpful in finding my place. I was right after this light blue feather. I had just right here. I was just working on the black, just started the black on that. So I worked two complete feathers since I picked this up this week. And I started this way back in April of 2013. And now for a whip that's not too old. I just started this year actually, and I didn't even make a project page for it because it was just something I was quickly doing to test out the yarn and how it worked with the pattern. So this is my hand spun. It's BFL from Friends in Fiber in the moss colorway. And I spun this up probably a couple years ago. 1 or 2 years ago. It's been a while on the needles. And I'm working the Viper scarf from Morehouse Designs. And they're little snakes. And they have felt tongues and bead eyes. And this is how this is turning out. I knit the head, you know, did all the increases and decreases, and now I'm just knitting plain garter stitch. So this would be a great beginner pattern for learning increasing and decreasing, and then you get a bit of a break with a lot of garter stitch knitting in the middle, and then you end off with more decreasing, of course, to make the snake shape. So I really like how this is working up. It's so fun to knit with your own hand spun, I think. It's nice to watch the colors progress and to feel how the yarn is working up. Now, I think this scarf would be more fashion than function. It's for my son, and you know, it's more as a decorative piece than for warmth, I would say. It might be a little scratchy for him to wear right against his neck. Spinning. I completed the half of a braid of Frobjes fibers. I think it's merino. Here's the other half of the braid. And here is the other center pull ball that I made with this first half of the braid. I am now going to take this, put it into a shoebox with little holes in the ends, and wind it into a center pull ball with my ball winder, and then I'll be able to ply these two together. I'm going to use my spindle, and we'll see how that goes. I haven't plied with my spindle in quite a while, not since I first started spinning and I didn't have a spinning wheel, because I feel like spinning with a spinning wheel, like, it's so much faster. Everything you do, like spinning wise, it's faster, plying it's faster, and I'm so anxious to see the finished results that I often go the quick route. I'm getting a new spindle for my birthday. I ordered one from Spin City UK, who used to be on Etsy. She now has her own shop, spincityshop.com. And she does lovely acrylic spindles. I think they're acrylic with pressed flowers and glitter. They're so fun. So I ordered one of those, and it should be shipped out next week sometime. I'm so excited. It won't be here for my birthday, but that's okay. Maybe here by Rhinebeck, maybe not. We'll see how that goes. It could take a while to get here from London. That's all I have for you today. I hope you have a great week and happy knitting.